All right, now we will talk about OPC UA, which is inside the PLC. We have OPC UA server in PLC next, and we can enable this server and we can use third-party application to read the tags of the PLC. All right, so let's see how we can do that. Step one is you go to this OPC UA here, and you have a DNS name or the IP address. I prefer to use the IP address, which is more easy to locate the OPC UA server. So I will put the IP address of my PLC, which is 192.168.1.110. So just put the IP address here, and then you will see visibility of variables, which variables you want to see. Okay, by default, I think it's at none. I will go to marked. So the marked variables I can see in my OPC UA client. So this is the server settings. The client will come later. I will tell you a client how to configure that. So in the server, we define the IP address, and now we will mark the variables. So you go to this PLC, in the data list, these are all the variables. So let's see the variables on which we have worked on in the last video. Let's visualize that. So we have input 0. I will make this tick for input 1, for output 0, for analog input output. And if I go down, I see some scaled tags, and maybe A, B, and X. Okay, so these are the tags I want to monitor on my OPC UA client. So this is the server settings. So once you define the tags, once you enable the OPC UA, put the IP address, just download that. Okay, one more thing, in this OPC UA, there are some security settings. I have put this no, and these are by default my yes. And there's another setting which I have disabled. I want to show you that. So if you go to your IP address and type WBM next to it and press enter, you will come to the screen, and maybe you have to log in. In my case, I have disabled the authorization. So once you log in, you will see the screen and you go to user authentication, and here I have disabled that. By disabling that, I don't have to enter ID and password again while connecting to OPC UA, because I'm working in my home and it's a local network. It's not connected to the internet, so I'm kind of safe. But in your case, maybe it's enabled, so you have to put ID and password, but I'm not doing that at the moment, okay? And the another reason why I'm not doing it is because in the future videos, I'm going to connect this to my factory IO, and in the factory IO, at the moment, there is no way to enter the ID and password for connection, so I have disabled that. Okay, so I go back to my PLC and download this logic, download these changes, not the logic, to my PLC. So it will write, it will download the project, and now we will open OPC UA client. Now the client will extract the value of these tags from the OPC UA server. That's the idea. Now client can be any third-party software. Maybe you have an OPC UA client already. If you don't, I'm using the one which is called UA Expert. These are third-party software which can take the value from the PLC, and you can develop some other softwares, some other application using these variables. So it's quite beneficial if you're working with IoT, you should know how to link via OPC UA. So in this client, I will add a server now. Now in this server, I go to custom discovery and double click to add it. So here, this is the syntax of OPC UA when you're defining an endpoint. So this is by default here. If you have any other third-party OPC UA software, you have to enter opc.tcp:// and then comes the IP address of the PLC, and after that put a colon, and there's a default port for OPC UA, which is 4840. You have to enter that. So this is the port at port number where the OPC values are coming. So click OK, and then you see this value here. Double click this one, you will see server, double click this one, and I click on none. And then it will ask you for the certificate. These are the certificate information in the PLC next. So I say trust and click continue. So now once I continue, you can see here it shows PLC next. Now what is in the PLC next? We have some, this is the folder ARP PLC. And if you open this, you will see all your tags. Now what are these tags? Let's take this analog scaled. I will put it here, and you can see the value is 3.58. So this is the value coming from analog input channel 1. So if I change it from my trainer, you can see it's increasing, and that's the same value we have in our HMI. So if I open the HMI here, user So analog input is right now 5.83. And if I open OPCA, you can also see the same value. So these are the values now coming in a different software, which is happening in the PLC. Similarly, you can see output scaled. So this is right at the moment zero. And if I change it from here, 3.67, you can see the value here. So that's the OPC value. Similarly, you can see the value for inputs, input 0 and 01. So these both are false. And now these are true, coming from the PLC. So PLC is sending this value to the port, and this OPC client is extracting this value from OPC US server. That was the idea of connection with OPC client and server together. So you can see all the tags which you have declared in the PLC program. We have ticked this tag, and you can see it here. And another important thing is how to define this tag. So if you see here, at the moment, I am selecting analog 01 scaled. And here you can see attributes. This is the node address. Now, this is the address which will give you the value of analog 01 scaled. This is the, you can say it's a kind of tag address. Okay, so this NS5, this is dynamically generated. This is the number. And this S is the string. Okay, this is the namespace index 5. This is the string. So you need these two together to link it to your OPC UA client. I will show you in the next video where we can use this value and how to display the value in another software. Okay, so this is very important. For any tag, you need to know the namespace index. You need to know if the identifier is string, sometimes identified as a number. So this is a string in this case. And you need to know the data type, which is float. Okay, that three things you need to know: namespace, index, identifier, if it's a string, what's the string, and the data type. So these values are required to view the data in third-party applications. So here you can just monitor the values. Now, how to use this value, stay tuned, we'll see in the next video.